Hi everyone, and welcome back to another episode of What I Watched This Week. We are already on week 10, as you can see in the background. Time flies, but 80 Passione is always and still here just to give you some company and to share with you the films that I watched this week. Let's start. I'm going to review 7 of them, so get comfy, prepare the popcorn, and first of all, subscribe to this channel and bring new friends. It's the only way to improve the quality of this channel and the content of all of my videos. But now, let's crack on! The first film that I watched this week, it's called Moxie, a 2021 comedy drama. Since The Breakfast Club, I have particular inclination for this type of film. Come on, do you remember Simple Minds? Don't you forget about me. Don't you forget about me. But let's go back to Moxie. Stories of rebellion, of teenagers who have to find their own balance in life. People who wonder who they are. They have to understand how to speak up in public. In this case, the particular emphasis is given to female characters with moments of humor and reflection at the same time. If you want to spend 2 hours taking a step back to the school desks, then get ready for a real revolution, baby! My score for this film, 7. Available on Netflix, at least here in the UK. And now let's move to the second film who I watched this week. It's called The Way Back, a 2010 drama based on a true story. Directed by the same director of Dead Poets Society, Captain or My Captain, and The Truman Show. A story that shows us how cruel and meaningless war can be. And at the same time, how strong the determination of a man guided by a promise can be. A promise of love. A man whose only goal is to return home, surviving an endless marathon of 4,000 miles in search of his freedom. If you like films that represent historical events with the touch typical of this director, Peter Weir, then get ready for this 2-hour and 13-minute journey. My score to this film, 7. To this director, 9. Available on Amazon Prime, at least here in the UK. But be aware, because there is another film called The Way Back with Ben Affleck, released in 2020. If you want to know everything about it, don't worry, because I made another video specifically on this film and is available on my channel under the playlist Cinema. Also, there is another one, because there is so much imagination in Hollywood, called The Way, Way Back, released in 2013, a good movie that I recommend with Sam Rockwell. And now, let's move to the third film that I watched this week, called... It's going to be even difficult for me. Oh, actually, I'm sorry, you know, the beauty of going live. It's called Hunger, a 2008 drama based on a true story and set in Northern Ireland. Probably I get excited every time it's Ireland, Northern Ireland, so this is why I got confused. The first feature film directed by Steve McQueen, a director who likes these strong themes, as he will do later on with Shame and 12 Years a Slave. Definitely a well-made film with a masterful interpretation by Michael Fassbender. Fassbender, it's even difficult to pronounce his name, who has proven to know how to get by in both dramatic and lighter roles, such as those played in the X-Men saga. an extremely sad story, not really suitable for everyone, extremely brutal and direct, which left me with a sense of great sadness once it was over. A film with a very intense message, but also a truly extreme one. I am speechless, and I believe that there is not necessary to add more. My score to this film, 7. To the interpretation of Michael Fassbender, 9. Available on Netflix, at least here in the UK. And now probably the film that you saw earlier, there is a little bit of confusion today. I think the fourth film that I watched this week, called John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum, a 2019 action, the third of this series, with a fourth that should be released in 2022, so next year. A film that received an average of 8.6 on IMDb and on Rotten Tomatoes, 89% of a general consensus of the people. It's no mystery now how I admire Keanu Reeves, who I enjoy watching in the first Matrix. By the way, they're going to release probably next year the number 4, and also in Speed, The Devil's Advocate, and Point Break, the original one with Patrick Swayze. Going back to John Wick, I saw the first two and I honestly do not understand what is so special about this character that is so popular with the public. It's still a mystery to me. A film in which you run from the first moment with the crazy shootings and the fighting scenes, but that personally seems a little nonsense to me. The only positive note is to see Keanu Reeves, aka Neo, and Larry Fishburne, aka Morpheus, starring the same film again. My score to this film? 6.5, but only because of Keanu. Available on Netflix, at least here in the UK, until the 31st of March, so you have more or less 3 more weeks to enjoy this film on Netflix if you're based here in the UK. And now let's move to the fifth film that I watched this week. I hope I'm going to pronounce correctly, called Coherence, a 2013 sci-fi thriller. I never thought that a passing comet could upset the lives of 8 friends gathered for dinner, and at the same time send me to bed with 1,000 doubts and such a mental confusion. Now I already know that those who have seen it will consider this film a masterpiece, a little gem of sci-fi movies, but it's not my case. I'm very sorry, I'm talking about you, Cesare. I know you love this film, but it's not my case. Maybe I'm getting old, like you usually repeat to me, Cesare, and this kind of mental trip films never fascinated me that much. Remember Inception? Yes, the same. Or I have to see it again in the afternoon. Probably I will give, you know, another try this weekend. Who knows? And it's not very long, only 89 minutes. But I wasn't able at the first shot to follow the logic of the plot very much. And even the ending left me disorientated. If you love brain teasers and you want to share with me your interpretation of this film, then run and see it. My score to this film? Who knows? I'm still waiting for a passing comet. Available on Amazon Prime, at least here in the UK. And now let's move to the sixth film that I watched this week, called Trial by Fire, a 2018 drama based on a true story. A film that once again demonstrates the absurdity of the death penalty, or as it's called in Texas, the ultimate justice. The fight against time of a woman who will do everything to prove the innocence of a man unfairly sentences to death, and how much evidence can be hidden or manipulated. An epilogue with atrocious implications that will show us how far the cynicism of the human being can go. Jack O'Connell, remember this name, Jack O'Connell, an English actor, once again proves to be very good as a main actor and perfect in these dramatic roles. An actor that I enjoy watching a lot. Much more than Leonardo DiCaprio, by the way. If you like movies that question some aspects of the American justice system, this is one worth seeing. My score for this film, 7. To Jack O'Connell, 8. Available on Netflix, at least here in the UK. And now, let's move to the 7th and the last film that I watched this week, called The Best of Enemies, a 2019 drama based on a true story. A film that starts slowly, as well as the relationship between CP and Han, the two main protagonists. A story of a friendship between two worlds that are apparently the opposite. A film that shows us, once again, how determination and faith can break down any mental prejudice. Because remember, every human being has a heart of the same color, and CP will have to understand what is willing to sacrifice in order to do the right thing. Sam Rockwell proves once again that he's a complete actor capable of interpreting these dramatic roles with his own style. Recommended for all those who believe in values such as equality and friendship. My score to this film, 7. Available on Netflix, at least here in the UK. So, that's all with the films that I watched this week. In perfect 80 passione style, today, Saturday, 13th of March, it's a special birthday. It's a William H. Macy birthday. Happy birthday, William. He turns 71. I really, really love you in your role in Fargo, but also in your role as Frank Gallagher in Shameless USA. So you were fantastic, and as well, sorry, I forgot, in ER, you were a fantastic doctor. So you are very versatile. I always appreciated this quality in you. But now, before leaving you, tomorrow here in the UK is going to be Mother's Day. So I wish to all the moms in the UK, and as well to my mom who is in Italy, never mind if in Italy we celebrate in May, so it's a good occasion just to send her all of my love, to all the special women with children here in the UK. I hope it's going to be a sunny day, so we are all going to be able to spend a lovely day. That's all for this week. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, share this video with whoever is in love with the cinema or TV series. I'm finishing watching a couple of very interesting TV series, so next week I'm going to tell you more. Leave your comments in case you watch any of these films, in particular those ones who I couldn't understand. Yeah, the sci-fi thriller, I'm talking about that, Cesare, so you can basically give your best and give me some lessons. And that's all for today. Like I usually say, ciao!
No, dear, I'm there.
I feel like clutching.